Today we learn a few things about Python data analysis. So have you practiced the things that I have shared on Git with you? Any doubts, any queries? Code written by us, written by me is functional. Len function is basically used to fit the length of a list, a tuple, or anything. Like how many number of elements you have in a list or a tuple. The code written by me was not functional. It was simply script. Functional, you say the functional when I will use some functional programming concepts, like if I'm creating functions, nested functions, something like that. So he was just simply writing the script. We cannot say that this is some sort of a functional programming right now. And have you guys watched the video of Matplotlib I shared with you on WhatsApp group? Hello, voice is not clear. Am I clear? Am I audible, everyone?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Okay, so yesterday a video was shared with you all. That was related to Matplotlib. Okay, so we have a channel, one is Brain Mentors. You can go through with this channel and you will find a lot of videos on Python and also Matplotlib in 15 minutes that was shared with you all yesterday. Okay, so if you guys want to just go through with this, then I'm sharing the YouTube link of this video. You can go through with this video. Okay, and there are also two videos, Python tips and tricks. Please go through with this video also, so you will learn a lot of things about Python tricks, that what are the things that you can do easily in Python in just 2 or 3 lines of code. So it will help you to improve your programming concepts, to get up detailed knowledge of syntax in just few line of code. Okay guys, so now I'm going to start the session. Is there any doubt related to web crawling or anything? We have to choose the class name. Please help me choosing the class name. Yeah, you can choose the class name, like whatever the website you are crawling. You just have to do one thing. Let's say when we was crawling flipkart.com, and if you want to fetch any information from this website, like if you want price, title, this description and all, you just have to right click on that particular content and then right click and then go to inspect. So in the inspect window, there will be some tag and there will be some class also. Okay, there will be a tag and there will be a class also. So you might have one class or two class or three class. You can just copy all of them with the tag. That's it. That's the only thing you have to do whenever you are crawling something. Yes, there are many
Excuse me, sir.
classes.
Excuse me, sir. There are many classes, but which to choose the correct one? How to choose the correct class?
Basically, to choose the correct classes, first you must have the understanding of CSS, the style sheet. But if you are not clear with CSS, then you can pick all the classes. And also, I don't know which class will be used at somewhere else. Might be this class is used a lot of time in this particular web page, but the probability of these two classes being used together is low. There will be only probability like wherever Flipkart want to display the price of any item, it will be showing these two classes. Let's check another one. You will see the same classes. Okay, again, let's right click inspect. Again, you will see the same classes. So that's how you have to recheck again and again. Please show with another one like what, another website, some other website you want to check. Okay, let's go to indeed.com. Okay, so if I visit indeed.com and search here Python and find jobs, then we'll show you these jobs. So now if I want to fetch these jobs, what I have to do is I have to right click, go to inspect again, and there you will see a tag with a class. Simple. So this will give you the company name. You want something else, like if you want the salary, the package they are giving. So it is inside another span tag with salary text class. If you want something else, like the information about the location and all, then it will be inside a div tag with these classes. Now here a lot of classes are available: location, accessible, contrast, color, location. So in this point, I can just access the location class, because the second class name like contrast, color, location will be associated with some coloring and all. So it might be given to give some contrast colors and all. So that's why I can just pick location. But if there is any confusion, then you can copy both the classes. Okay. Okay, is it clear now? If a class contain table, how to display it? If a class contain table, like if a table contains class, like we fetch the data from ESPN. So ESPN displays the data in a tabular format like this. So if you want to fetch this type of data, then simply go to inspect, and it will show you the table with a class. Now it depends on you whether you want to fetch full table or you just want to fetch the rows one by one. So all the rows have the same class known as data one. So you can just write find all tr tags where class is equals to data one. Okay, getting a point? Okay, so now let's move forward. So our first part, data analysis, we introduced yesterday. Is there any doubt related to data analysis and visualization? Div is available in every inspect because div is one of the major tags that is used to build websites. But there will be other tags also: H2, H3, H4, H5, H6, paragraph tag, span tag, image tag. There are a lot of tags. A tag. Okay. Is there any doubt related to the data analysis that we did yesterday? So have you tried this with your states? P means paragraph. There are various type of graph. Can we know a bit more about that? Yeah, we can have the knowledge about graph. So this was the graph that we saw yesterday. So have you tried this graph with your states or not? With different locations? Have you tried this code? Okay, try these things. Okay, so you will get a lot of knowledge about visualization part. Now we'll move forward and display. Let's say here we have the confirmed cases for Maharashtra. Okay, so what I will do is I will copy this line. And instead of this, we can do one thing. Just paste this line here and you can change the state. So instead of MH, let's write DL, that is Delhi. Now, if I want to do a comparison between Delhi and Maharashtra, then just copy this code of graph, paste it here. Again, copy this line, paste and write DL. Now you will have two lines. Now this is the comparison graph for Maharashtra versus Delhi. But which line is of Delhi and which line is of Maharashtra? So we will give a label. Label is equals to, let's write the name of label is, this one is for Maharashtra. So I'm just writing MH. And let's write here DL. And finally, you just need to write plt.legend. Now you will be able to see. Okay, so what is your doubt? You can ask the doubts, whatever doubts you have. Okay. Python installation are not working in Anaconda. So you can switch to Google Colab. So what exactly the problem you are facing? Or is there anyone else who is facing problem in installing Anaconda? So Anjali ma'am, can you please tell me what exactly the problem is?
Hello sir.
Already there are a lot of packages in Google Colab, so you might not need to do that. So there are packages already available.
Sir, Anjali here, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, actually, I have installed Anaconda and it is opening the environment. I have written instructions, but the instructions are not executing after pressing shift enter.
Please repeat the last line you said.
When I have written the instructions A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, and then pressed shift enter, it is not executing.
Okay, so what it is showing you right now?
In between, it has given the error that Python is stopping working.
Okay, for right now, ma'am, you can do one thing. Like we have only 2 to 3 days, so you can do one thing. Just switch to Google Colab immediately. If you are facing any issue with Anaconda Navigator for the particular time limit, then you can switch to Google Colab. Okay. Later, after completing the sessions and all, later you can contact me. I'll fix your Anaconda problem. Okay.
Okay, sir. Actually, I have installed Anaconda in E Drive. Can that be a problem?
No, I don't think so. It's okay. It's installed there.
Okay, sir.
But still, you can do one thing. If you want to work with Anaconda, you can do one thing. Uninstall it and reinstall it again in C drive. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Till
सर
then,
थैंक
please switch
यू.
to Google Colab.
ओके सर थैंक यू.
How to work with Anaconda? A video was shared, I guess, with WhatsApp, on your WhatsApp group, that how to work with Anaconda Navigator. So have you gone through this video, Nimal sir? You can just go through with the video. Let me share the link again. How to work with Anaconda Navigator. Let me share it again with you. So this is the link from where you can just go through this video and just you can compare. Like what exactly a problem you are facing. Okay. Okay. Now, so let's move forward. So we just plotted two one graph here with two different states. So there are two lines. You can see the comparison graph here for Delhi and Maharashtra. So this blue line is of Maharashtra and this orange line is of Delhi, showing you the confirmed cases we are getting of COVID-19. Okay, I will share one link. From that we will get to know that how to change the browser. Okay, on WhatsApp group I will share the link. Basically, there is nothing new today we are doing here. Just this was the yesterday's code. Okay, this is all the code that we did yesterday. The only code that I did today is the two lines, confirmed cases of Delhi, and then just plotted this graph. This is the only code that I have written in this session. Okay, guys. So I think we need to move forward now. Which code you want to see? Because the codes are already uploaded on GitHub. This file is already available on GitHub. All the codes are available. Okay, you can go through with that, and this is the only code I have written now. Okay, rest of the codes are available in GitHub. So now I am plotting plt.bar. And let's plot the confirm square bracket DL comma this is it. So here we have not DL, we'll do one thing. We have DF data frame. Yesterday I showed you the bar plot. So how many plots we have seen already? Pie chart, bar plot, I guess. So here we have bar plot, pie charts, and line plots. Okay, so there are a lot of graphs that we did yesterday using CMOM, and then we can do plt.scatterplot. Here you can also pass the same parameter like confirm and this thing. So that's how you can do the scatterplot. Okay, this is the example of scatterplot. What is univariate and multivariate? Univariate means simple, a unique variable. You have only one single column you have, but in multivariate you have multiple features with you. Okay, now when I will start with machine learning, I will tell you that what exactly univariate or multivariate are exactly known for. Okay, so guys, I think we can start with the next part because we have seen few type of graphs and few more graphs will come in future when we'll start working with machine learning part. Okay. So now finally, I'm just closing this data analytics part. I think we need to move forward. Okay, so shall we move forward now? Because we need to start machine learning. Okay, guys, so now I am going to start machine learning part. So now when I generally talk about machine learning, the first we have completed is the data analytics and basics of data processing and all. Data processing will come again when we'll be working with the data of images and text. Then again we'll talk about data processing. Okay, now we'll do one thing. First we'll understand the basic introduction to machine learning. But before starting the machine learning part, I want to know the definition from your side. Like, what exactly you think the definition of machine learning is? Yeah, I'll start from very basic. Like, what exactly machine learning is? I will start from that point. Okay, but before going to the details, I just want to know from your side, like, what exactly your prior knowledge is about machine learning. What do you think? What exactly it is? Okay. Okay. Can the machine start acting like human, making the machine learn from data, training the data, how to learn the machine to work like human? Taking a model from dumb to intelligent. Definition of AI. Okay. Okay, tell me one thing. Okay. We say machine learning, like the term state that the machine is learning something. Okay. But what exactly machine is learning? Machine is learning what? Relation between excitation and responsiveness. Algorithms, bias, weights, model in the form of weights. Okay. Knowledge based on past experience, we have to give some intelligence to the machine to organize the algorithms. With experience, okay. Okay, so we have got a lot of answers about machine learning. Let's get started with it. Okay, if you want to understand what exactly machine learning is, what exactly the definition is. Like, if we have 80 candidates, then everyone will give us something new definition for it. We'll understand this thing by example. Okay. First, exactly what is the definition of machine learning in a single line, okay, in a single statement, you will see the definition of machine learning, that what exactly it is, how to define it in technical terms. So have you heard about Alan Turing? I hope so. You might have heard about Alan Turing, the Turing machines. So basically, machine learning is not a new definition today. It was introduced early in 1947. Okay, we do not have to remember about Turing machine. We just have to remember a definition that Alan Turing gave. That is, what we want is a machine that can learn from experience. And believe me, this is the best definition I have ever seen of machine learning. There are a lot of definitions available on the internet, but this is the only definition that I just want to learn. What we want is a machine that can learn from experience. That's it. Simple one. And this definition was given in 1947. When we was fighting with each other, India and Pakistan was fighting with each other, this guy was giving the definition of machine learning. Then he was telling the future, that in future you need to learn something like this. Okay, so this is the basic definition of machine learning. And after that, how we are going to understand on a basic level, how we are going to understand on a zeroth level understanding. So let's take example. So is there anyone who is not aware of cricket, like what exactly it is? I hope everyone is like aware of cricket. So here I will take example of it. So let's say the example is, India need 8 runs to win with 10 wickets in hand and 6 balls are remaining. Situation. What will happen now? What will happen? Tell me, guys. India will win. Everyone is saying that India will win. Anything. Okay, is there anyone who is not aware of the situation, who don't know what is happening here? Is there anyone from the participants who is not getting this, what exactly it is written here? You might have not watched cricket yet. So India will lose. So why India will lose? Money here, why India will lose? Are you against India? Okay, so now basically when we start talking about what exactly will happen, the situations, everyone is telling that India will win. Now my question is, India will either win or lose. We have only two situations. India will either win or lose. You are saying India will win. The question comes, how can you be so sure? How can you do prediction? How can you be so confident about the outcome? Okay, like a lot of people were giving this answer that India will win. Now the question to all of you is that, how can you be so sure? How do you know that India will win the match? Based on past experiences, you might have seen a lot of cricket matches earlier. From the childhood, you might be playing this type of cricket matches. And according to your experience, you are thinking that obviously this kind of situation, a team will always win in this kind of situation. Okay. Now, after that, there are a lot of cricket matches that you have seen earlier. There are a lot of situations that you might have gone through. And all the memory of these cricket matches are stored in your brain. Am I right? Are you agree with me? From your childhood or from your last few years, whenever from the time you have started watching the cricket matches, you are just watching them and the situations and the scenarios are present in your mind. Like what exactly happened in which match. Okay. Now, based on those experiences, based on those situations, I was able to get this answer to you. But what will happen if I start a baseball game in front of you? Now, can you do a prediction? Who will win? If I start a baseball match in front of you, can you do the prediction? Who will win? Anyone know about baseball? No idea? So if you are not watching baseball, if you are not learning anything, then you cannot do any kind of prediction at that moment. Okay, so that's the difference come. Whatever you are learning, you are giving predictions on that. Whatever you are not learning, you cannot do predictions based on those things. Okay. Now, the next thing is, what if computer do this for you? What if my computer do the same that you are doing? Like you are telling me that India will win the match. But what if my computer will tell me this thing? By doing some predictions with some accuracy scores. To do that, we need to train our machines. And if it means, we need to share our experiences with you. Now, pay attention to this part very carefully. Okay. It means we need to share our experiences with machine. How to do that? Because how a machine can learn from past experiences of human? Understand this thing. Imagine this thing. Because humans have memory in different form, we can learn from videos, images, or playing the game by ourselves. There are a lot of ways that human can learn the things. Getting a point, everyone? Like right now, you are learning something from me. You can learn something from YouTube. You can watch the videos. You can just practice these things by yourself, but a computer cannot do all these things. So how a computer will be able to perform all these operations? Let's get into it. So how machine? Let's see. There are three steps I have written. First, we will collect the data of previous matches in form of numbers. Okay, you will collect the data of the cricket matches like we was doing in ESPN. I was showing it. All the data has been written in ESPN website. Second point, store that data in file like Excel or any other format. Now, our machine can read that data easily because we know how to perform file handling and all. So that's how machine will get the data. This is the first step that we have completed, that how to give data to your machines. Is this clear to you all? First step. Am I clear till here? Is there any doubt to anyone? Okay, now let's give an example. Suppose I have collected a data of cricket, something like this. It is like opening partnership of India, that how many runs the partnership, the opening partnership has made in how many balls and what was the result of that match. Okay, let's say if opening partnership just faced 100 balls and made 125 runs, the result was win. So similarly, I have data of Indian cricket team, only the opening pairs, opening partnership. So if the opening partnership is like this and the partnership is this, then what was the result? Something like this. Simple data I am showing you here. Now, after looking at the data, after looking at the opening partnerships, our machine will learn that whenever the opening pair of India build partnership of more than 100 runs in less ball, there is a chance of more than 80% that India win the match. Can I conclude this thing by writing this statement? I was just showing you one data, this, and now after looking at this data, I'm doing my conclusion that after looking at this data, I can say that whenever Indian partnership, the opening partnership plays less ball and made more runs, then there are 80% chances that India wins the match. Simple one. Is this point clear to you all? Any doubt till here? Okay. Now, after looking at this data, I will say that I am going to plot this thing on graph. The ball versus score. Okay, like the balls you are playing here on the y-axis, score is on x-axis. So this is the graph of ball versus this score. And the blue lines here, the sky blue, the color you are seeing here is for the win, and the black is for lose. So whenever ball was more but score was less, there was a losing chance. So when the score was more, the ball was less, so there was a chance of winning the game. So here we have only two situations, either lose or win. Okay. After that, I'm just building a circle around these two so you can understand there are two different classes, lose and win. Simple one. Now after that, there is a new input. What will happen? What will be the outcome of the match? Because today, if India is playing, then I can see the balls are more, but the score is really very less. So that's where my point is lying. So I can simply say India is going to lose the match because it is lying at the weak circle of lose. Mamta ma'am, please turn off your mic. Let's say we have another situation now. This was the lose. You just predicted, right? So this was the lose. And now, let's say this is the new input. Now what will happen? Is something like India is making like 100 for 100 runs. Now what will happen? Or answers. I need more answers from you guys. Chances to win, 50-50% chances, probability needs to be applied. So what I will do, okay, is it still equal? The input is the new input. If this is the situation of right now, the game is here. So like India is making 100 ball and 100 run. Now I want to predict that whether India will win the match. Okay, now after that, I just made a circle around my new input, and I just have captured my nearest points. My nearest point, like win and lose, what exactly they are. So I have now five points in this circle. These are the closest can see. Majority of win is the majority of lose. So I have only one point of lose and four of win. Okay, so that's why I can say we are going to win the match. And how are we going to win using this form? So I hope so you might be learning about this formula a lot of times. That is known as the Euclidean, the popular Euclidean distance formula you can use, and you just find out the distance from your target with each data point. And after that, you just figure it out that which are the five nearest points, and according to those five nearest points, the majority of win or lose you can check. So that's how machine learning is applied here. That's how mathematics is applied here. Okay, am I clear to all of you? Is this point clear, everyone? Any doubts now? This was the simple machine learning definition according to myself. And I think this was one of the simple examples that I have taken to understand what exactly, how exactly machine will learn the things. Right now, machine is not learning, it is just performing some calculation. We'll see how machine is going to learn with time. Okay. So we can have the machine learning like a type of AI used to allow machines to learn from experiences like human. An idea to build algorithm that can receive input data and use some math to predict an output. These are the simple definitions that I have written here. A lot of examples you can have, like car detection we have, red light detection we have, or in today's time, your challan get cut if you will cross the speed. So there are a lot of things that are going on, a lot of applications. But when we talk about machine learning types, so what are the types of machine learning? We have four types of machine learning: supervised, unsupervised, reinforcement, and semi-supervised. We have four types of machine learning. Okay, now we'll understand about these things by taking some examples. Let's say we have a situation here. We have X and we have Y. Instead of here, I will do one thing. Okay, now let's have an example. Let's say you have X and Y. There is one X and there is one Y with you. X is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And Y is, let's say, 2, 4, 5, 4, 5. Simple. Now I will do one thing. I will plot my X and Y on graph. Okay, now let's plot 1 by 2. Two with 4. Three with 5. 4 with 4, and then 5 with 5. So I have just created a graph in front of you. We have X and Y. Okay. Basically, right now we are learning what exactly machine is going to learn. First of all, when I talk about different types of machine learning, there are four types, but we'll understand with examples what exactly supervised, unsupervised, each and everything I'll tell you. Okay, for right now, I will write down for you that so that you will remember. We are talking right now about machine learning. And machine learning is majorly divided into two parts, that is supervised and unsupervised, majorly. And when we say supervised, then the target is known. That is, target is already known to us. Target is already available for us. And again, supervised is divided into two parts, regression and classification. And in regression, we generally talk about a data which is continuous. So here we learn linear regression kind of problem. One of the easiest algorithm of machine learning, that is linear regression. And then we have classification. And in classification, we generally talk about categorical type data. And the algorithms are something like logistic regression. We have KNN, that is K nearest neighbors, naive Bayes, decision tree, SVM, that is support vector machine. Okay, simple one. So I have just written here the machine learning, the one part of machine learning that is supervised. So first we'll understand what exactly supervised is. Okay, so I was taking an example for you. Like I have X and Y. Let's say X is your study hours and Y is the marks you are getting. Okay, so X is study hours and Y is the marks. So if someone says that I study 4 hours and get 80%, if someone says that I study 5 hours and get 85%, if someone is saying I study for 7 hours and I get 92%, if someone is saying 6 hours and I get 82%, I study for 2 hours, I get 70%. Now, a student comes and he says that I study for 3 hours, what will be my percentage? How you will calculate? How? By plotting graph. But how you will predict by plotting the graph? Because on the graph you will see your X and Y. So basically what I am going to do here, let me tell you step by step. Okay, what we have to do here is we are given with some X and with some Y. We are already aware of the marks of those students who study these number of hours. We just need to calculate for this thing. The first thing you have to do is to find out the relation between X and Y. Okay, the first thing is you need to find out a relation between X and Y, like how X is related with Y. So if I say whenever X is increasing or decreasing, is my Y is also depending on that? So that's why you say your X as a independent variable and you say Y as a dependent variable. Okay, or X is also known as feature and Y is known as target. Are you getting my point, everyone? X is known as the independent because if X change, then Y also change because Y depends on X. Similarly, X is known as my feature and Y is here my target that I need to calculate that is already given to you, but for a new data. Using my previous data, I need to calculate the new one. So that's where we can just plot these things on graph and all like this. And then there is a simple formula, and this formula used to calculate the best fit line, y is equals to mx plus c, because here I can see there is a linear relationship that could be built between x and y, because as my x is increasing, y is also increasing. So here I can easily see that x and y are related linearly. So that's why I'm saying the linear equation is y is equals to mx plus c. Is it simple or not? Any doubt in this particular scenario? Okay, so that's where we say that this type of learning is a machine learning. Okay, why we say this type of learning is a machine learning? Because we have already provided the y variable. We was already given the target variable. That 80%, 85%, all the things was previously in front of you. You just need to find out the average and something like that. But 6% is less than 5R. It's okay. There is. I just did because so that I can do some variation in my data. Okay. Okay, so now I was talking about, like, if you have already available y, you just can look at the next x, what it is, and find out the next y. Okay, we'll do this simple thing mathematically, step by step. But first, this type of learning is said to be the supervised. Why? Because there was already a supervision going on. There was already a y available to you. There was already some target which was available to you. Okay. So first I told you that we have machine learning, and then we say regression and supervise. And supervise where target is known. But if I say that you are only given with x, let's say there is x1 and x2. How to predict which formula to apply? But if supervised targets are already known, then my machine has to find the target. Let me answer one by one. So first, how to predict which formula to apply, we'll see after looking at all the algorithm. Then I will tell you that how you are going to find out that which formula we have to apply. Then, but in supervised targets are already known, then why machine has to find out the target? Machine has to find the target for the new x, okay? Because this 3 is not available in my data. So that's why I have to do the prediction for 3. 3 is not available in my x. That's why I have to do the prediction for 3. Okay, is it clear? Now we have x1 and x2. Instead of y, we have x1 and x2. x2 is might be the hours you play. Let's say who is studying 4 hours is playing 1 hour. Who is studying 5 hours? Let's say he is playing 2 hours. He's playing 1 hour. Who is studying 7 hours? He's also playing for 1 hour. Who is studying for 6 hours? He's playing for 2 hours. Who is studying for 2 hours? He's playing for 3 hours. And who is studying for 3 hours? We have to find out that whether he will pass or not. Now, you have only x1, x2. There is no y. I want to check that if I study for 4 hours and I play only 1 hour, what will be my result? Either I will pass or fail. So how I will do that thing now? Because I don't know whether these students was pass or not. Because there was no y available, there was no target available. So what we are going to do at these kind of situations, there will be a group of data, a group of students who are going to pass, and there will be a group who is going to fail. Or let's say first division, second division, I can just divide on any of the category. So there will become different clusters for us. X1 is study hours. X2 is your playing hours. Okay, after that I plotted my X1 versus X2. And then it is going to create clusters for you. Because there was no y available, there was no target available. So that's where we say that this type of learning is अनसुपरवाइज लर्निंग. इज दिस पॉइंट क्लियर टू यू ऑल? And after that, we have only one thing that we can do in unsupervised, that is classroom. What is unsupervised? Unsupervised is basically that type of learning where we do not have any target available. We have to classify the data, but there is no target available. Okay, that's where we say that this is unsupervised kind of learning. Dr. Tusky, please check your internet connection because I think there is problem from your side. And I'm audible to rest of the audience, so please check your connection once. Okay, so in clustering we have A means clustering algorithm. There is a DB scan algorithm. There is a mean shift. So we have different kind of okay, I'll explain the unsupervised again. Wait a minute. Okay. Target is not known. Yeah, exactly. Target is not available. Target is not known to us. Let me explain unsupervised again. Difference between classification is and clustering. There is no difference between classification and clustering. Both are doing the same thing. The difference is between target is available to you or not. Okay, target is available or not. That's where the difference comes. So in clustering, you are also doing the classification. Now let me explain unsupervised again. Okay, we have three column, x1, x2 and x3. You can take this example related to your college. What happens in college, like when you take admission in college, you do not have any friend, but after 1 year or 2 year there are a lot of groups roaming around. That's what happened in colleges. At the first day, at the second day, you will start making the friends. What kind of friends you are going to make that are similar to you? There will be a group of the people who loves to dance. There will be a group of people who likes to do some sports activities. There will be a group of studious students. There will be also a group of people who always fight. Am I right? We have these kind of categories in college available or not? Whenever you take admission in college, or like you are a teacher, you know, by the in whatever college you are teaching in, you can see there is a group of each and everyone different. There is a group of dancers, there is a group of sports, there is a group of studious students, there is a group of people who always get into some fights. Now, if a new student is coming in your college to take admission, which group he will join? In which group he will come? Whether he will join the dance, sports, study or fight? How you are going to assign this person to which group? So you will take inputs from this person, like whether you like dance, whether you like sports, whether you like study, or whether you loves to fight or not, depends on what he likes exactly. So this person will be shifted to that group based on his or her character exactly. So I have written here x1, x2, x3. Okay, these are the features. Like let's say x1 is the hobby, x2 is the marks, and X3, let's say we have the attendance percentage, somewhat like this. We have X1, X2, X3, something like this. Now you are seeing that the person hobby is sports, marks are also less, like 40%. Attendance will always, obviously it is also going to be short, because he's always involved in sport activities. So let's say his attendance is 60%. Okay, now some other person is coming, his hobby is to study. He has the marks percentage of 80 and attendance of 90. Okay. Now let's say if a new student comes to your college, he takes admission, he says that my hobby is to hobby is in sports. Okay. But my marks are high, 80%, and my attendance is also good. In which group, in which cluster you are going to store this person? Getting a point, everyone? This is a new data, and it is more likely that this person will go to the group of those type of people, the steady one, because the probability, I know the hobby is sports, I know the hobby is sports, but it is more likely to go in a steady group, in a steady cluster. Because if he loves sports, but he is not involved in sports, because if he is involved in sports, then his marks and attendance will hamper, obviously. But this thing is not happening here. Getting my point, everyone? So that's why you need to check where this cluster is going to, is likely to be lying. Okay, so this was a basic example of clustering, that we have to cluster the similar type of users together in a group. I think it is clear now, all of you. Is it clear to you all? So this thing happens a lot of time. You watch movies, then recommendation could be done based on this clustering. Like, you love to watch action movies only, so Netflix or Amazon Prime will recommend you the action movies only. Okay, yeah, this is unsupervised. When you are not aware of target. Okay, so target was not aware. Like, if I already assign a buyer to this type of people, like if already you are given a why, then it will become a supervise. Let's move forward now. So finally, I hope you all are now clear with this thing, that there is supervised, then there is unsupervised. How these things are different. One example, we were having the target. In one, we do not have the target. That is the buyer. That is the main level that we have to do the prediction. Now, supervises again. And classification. So regression means that the Y, the target column, will have some continuous value. Continuous means that could be infinite. It could be anything. Okay. What will be the value of Y? The value of the Y will be a cluster, either this or that. Let's say you have four options, you have four clusters, then 0, 1, 2, 3. These are the clusters, and I will assign Y 0, 1, 2, or 3 based on in which cluster you belong. Okay, I will assign that particular Y value to you. Let me tell you one more real life example. Okay, do you use Google Photos application in your mobile phone? There is a Google Photos. Do you guys use that application, Google Photos? It's a great example of clustering. What Google Photos do, it cluster similar type of people together. Let's say you have four friends, and it is going to cluster your friend one, your friend two. Let's say you have your parents pick in your mobile phone, it is going to cluster them. Let's say this is your father and this is your mother photos here, it is going to cluster them. Now let's say if you are clicking a new pic, if you clicked a new photo today, now Google is going to save this pic in either 1, 2, 3, or 4, in which of the cluster, whatever person it is going to belong. And if it is not similar to anyone, then it will create a new cluster. Are you getting my point? That's what Google Photos do. It cluster all the similar type of people, like the same person in a cluster. You can take that example. Okay. Okay, guys, now let's move. So I was telling you about the regression classification. Basically, regression means spontaneous type of data, like the target that is being provided to you is spontaneous. And by spontaneous, it means it could be any infinite number. Let's say if I ask you what is your salary, it could be anything. It could be 1 lakh, it could be 50,000, it could be 1 crore, it could be anything. But what if I ask what is your gender? Either you are male or you are female. You do not have like a lot of options. So if I say there is a cricket match today of India and Pakistan, who is going to win? Either India or Pakistan. We have only two options. Or let's say it is going to tie. So we have three options: India, Pakistan, or tie. But what if I ask how many runs India will make? What will be your answer then? Any infinite number again, 100, 200, 300, 400, any number could be there. So that's why we say it could be a continuous number, it could be a continuous data, where y is any infinite number. But when we say classification, it means y is either belong to a category. One more example, let's say election are coming, okay? And we have 3 to 4 options, like who is going to become the next prime minister of India? I will put the options in front of you. Like I will pick the four options and I will put them here. Okay, so I will ask you, who is going to become the next prime minister of India? You have four options. Now you say like Modi is going to become again the next prime minister. Now I will ask you, how many seats will Modi win? Okay, getting my point, everyone? Yeah, I know there could be finite. At some point, it will be finite, obviously, maybe a range. But again, it is some sort of a value which we cannot predict easily. There could be anything. Actually, if you have a range of 1 to 500, then it could be anything between 1 to 500. Okay? So that's why I'm using the word infinite here. Okay, guys. So now I think it is clear to you all that there is supervised, unsupervised, and regression, classification, and clustering. So these are the algorithms. Right now, I'm not going to talk about the algorithm part. I'm just going to talk about linear regression first. So using this linear regression, I'm going to tell you that how actually machine is going to learn something, how to do the prediction, how to perform basic regression analysis using Python. Okay, so let's move forward and let's see this example. Okay guys, so now we have x and y with us. So I just plotted x and y. Please complete first all the types. First all the types means, Vikas sir, please repeat your question. What exactly you want to see? All four types of ML. Okay, right now we are just going to cover supervised, unsupervised. If you want to talk about unsupervised and reinforcement, then I will give you overview. Okay, because reinforcement must be it will not be easily understandable if you don't know about machine learning and deep learning. After learning about deep learning and machine learning, you will be easily understand that how exactly reinforcement learning works. I can tell you, just let me tell you. Okay, if you are asking this thing, then let me tell you. Okay, so we have supervised, unsupervised, semi-supervised, and reinforcement. Okay, so I guess supervised and unsupervised is clear to you. I'm just giving you the intro of semi-supervised and reinforcement. Okay, so basically semi-supervised learning come into the role when I was having the y column with few missing values. You have y, you have target, but at few places the y is not available. At few places y is available. Now what will be your strategy? Anyone, any answer? This is not a classification, this is not regression. Like what I will do now, I have a target column, okay? I am giving you a target column, but few of the values in target are missing. That's where we say it is a semi-supervised learning. Getting my point, everyone? I'm just telling you right now the meaning of semi-supervised, okay? So semi-supervised means you have a target. Basically, if you want to take example of semi-supervised, then I will prefer don't use it. If the target is like few places target is missing, either do one thing, either get all the targets or remove all the targets, either do clustering or do supervised, according to me. But if it is like required, then you have to do semi-supervised, then you need to study a lot because there are different algorithms that are used in semi-supervised. You have to learn, you have to train that algorithm based on previous targets and all. So there are a lot of different things. Practically, it is used. It's not like that we are not going to use it. It is not used in any development. It is used, but it is not like recommended very much. Okay. It's okay. It's kind of okay thing. Like you can use it, but it's not recommended to go into detail of this thing for right now because this is not much popular. Then reinforcement learning is one of the popular learning, which is very helpful, but this learning will be understandable only if you know a lot of things about machine learning, deep learning, then you can understand how reinforcement learning works. It basically works on a principle of reward and punishment. So this is a strategy that we use to teach everyone, to our kids, to dogs, to anything that we are going to train. If it is going to train the thing successfully, if it is giving you output successfully, then you are going to reward it or you are going to punish it. By punishing means I'm going to restart my algorithm from zero position, again, from the first index. So that's the punishment for my system. You can take example of signals or anything. There could be a lot of examples. Generally, we talk about reinforcement learning in gamings and all. Let me tell you one example of it. Robotics, yeah, exactly. In robotics, it is used most of the times. OpenAI Gym. This is a website that is totally built for the examples of reinforcement learning. So if you want to learn more about what exactly reinforcement learning is or how it is implemented, then you can go through with this website. Gym is a package, Gym is a library that is used to build reinforcement learning. Okay, I'm sharing the link with you all. Okay. Shall we move forward now? Is it clear? And let me tell you one thing. If you are a beginner, then right now this is not the right time to go inside the detail of these two things. Just learn these two things perfectly first. Okay. After achieving these two things successfully, then you need to go towards these two. Okay, now, please repeat semi-supervised and reinforcement. So, semi-supervised learning is when you have target, but at few places, target is missing. At few places, target is not available to you. You have Y column available, but there are few places where target is missing. That is semi-supervised. And reinforcement is the type of learning where we apply reward and punishment strategy. Like if your algorithm is giving you predictions, then you keep going, keep going, keep going. And if your algorithm is not doing the predictions correctly, then you will restart it from the zeroth position. That is the punishment for it. Okay, the same way we train to our kids. Like if a kid is taking, if okay, let me give you best example. Okay, let me give you one example. Have you guys seen this movie? If you want to understand what is reinforcement learning, have you seen this movie or not? Anyone? No one has watched this movie. Oh my God. Okay, let me tell you one thing. If you want to understand the future of AI, the exactly what Reinforcement learning means just watch this movie. Okay, just watch this movie. It will make your day, definitely. Okay. And at the end, in the end, the thing will happen. One thing that the end is like just will blow your mind what exactly is going to happen at the end of this movie. Okay. So this is recommended from my side. Just watch it. You will understand a lot of things about AI. Real Steel movie is reinforcement. Kind of. Yeah, we can say that it is also a part of reinforcement, but there was no punishment included. But in this movie, there is a punishment also available. So there is reward and punishment in this movie. Okay, so that's why I'm recommending this. Or I will recommend you the movie that you are saying, Real Steel or some kind of that. Okay, guys, now let's move forward. Yeah, in Real Steel, there was reward, but no punishment. You can watch that if you feel like. Which technique use like clustering, classification, or regression in these two methods? The last two methods, reinforcement or semi-supervised, it depends. It depends. It's not necessary that it is either target is available or not. It depends. In these type of learning. This is self-learning kind of things. Okay, so I need to move forward because we have to complete this thing. So first, we was taking example of x and y here, x and y here. Let's do one thing. We just plotted x and y. Okay. Let's find out. So what will be the average of x and y? 3 plus 3, 6, 10, 15 divided by 5 is 3. 6 plus 5, 11 plus 4, 15 plus 5, 20 divided by 5, 4. So x is 3 and y is 4. So let's point it here, 3 by 4. Now, we know the formula is mx. Someone is asking you that if x is equals to 6, then what is y? If someone is asking my y. So that's why we need to calculate a linear relationship here. Okay. So formula you already know, y is equals to x plus c. So what is m here? So y is your prediction, m is your slope, x is your observation, or you can say data, and c is your intercept. Okay. Now what is this formula of slope? Formula of slope. Anyone? Dy by dx. That is the advanced level. But for this particular part, the formula of slope is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. And Dr. B. Ambu, hey guys, sorry, sir or ma'am, we are going to use this dy by dx in future. Okay, this will be our next step. Okay, so right now the formula for slope we have is dy by dx. Can I write this formula like this? Is it okay? Now let's calculate each and everything. X, y you already have. We want to calculate एक्स माइनस एक्स बार, देन एक्स माइनस एक्स बार होल स्क्वायर, देन वाई माइनस वाई बार, एंड देन एक्स माइनस एक्स बार मल्टीप्लाई विद वाई माइनस वाई बार. ओके, लेट्स कैलकुलेट देम वन बाय वन. वन टू थ्री फाइव, वाई वॉज टू फोर फाइव टू फाइव, एवरेज वॉज थ्री, एवरेज वॉज फोर, एक्स बार वाई बार. नाउ वॉट विल बी माई एक्स माइनस एक्स बार? इट विल बी वन माइनस थ्री माइनस टू, टू माइनस थ्री माइनस वन, जीरो वन टू. सो द सम विल बी, द सम विल बी जीरो. दैट्स वाई आई हैव रिटन हियर एक्स टू माइनस एक्स वन होल स्क्वायर. It will become 41014. Now the output will be 6. We got the denominator. So this is the denominator. Oh, sorry, this is 10. Okay. Denominator is 10. Now we have y minus y bar. That is 2 minus 4 minus 2, 4 minus 4 0, 5 minus 4 1, 4 minus 4 0, 5 minus 4 1. Now again 0. So that's why we have to do the multiplication of these two things. Now x minus x bar into y minus y bar, that is 4 0 0 0 2, it will become 6. Now what will be the value of slope? What will be the value of slope? Is it clear to everyone? Any doubts here? I want a confirmation from everyone. Please confirm everyone. Is it clear till here? Okay. So first, what we did is we had this x and y. I created the graph based on this x and y, plotted these things. Then the formula is, you know, y is equals to mx plus c, and we have the slope formula y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus y1 x1. So what I did is I just elaborate this formula by using x2 minus x1 into y2 minus y1, because I know I could get the zeros in numerator or denominator. So that's why I just built this table, and finally we got this slope, that is 6 by 10. So finally we have the slope is 0.6. What will be the intercept? So intercept will be y bar minus mx. So what is your y bar? 4 minus m is 0.6 into your x bar, that is. So what will be the value of intercept? Guys, tell me, what will be the value of intercept? Okay, so we will get the value of 6 into 3, 18.4.2.2. So it will be 2.2. Now you know the slope and intercept. The only thing you have to do is find out the prediction. Y cap is equals to mx plus c. It means m is 0.6. Let me write down here. And c is 2.2. Now let's calculate the prediction for each x. Okay. Now, 0.6 into 1 plus 2.2, 0.6 into 2.2. So now what you will going, you will just start doing calculation, 2.8, 2.4, 4.0, 4.6, 5.2. Okay. Now, if someone says that x is equals to 6, what is the y? That's it. You can find out. Now you can find out your x for any value, whatever your x is, because you have slope and intercept. Now we'll do one thing. I'm going to plot all these values on graph 2.8, 3.4. So for the first two, we have 2.8. Then we have 3.4. Always remember one thing. Whatever line you are going to create, the best fit line will always intersect your average. Remember this thing. It will always intersect from this mean point, this average point. 4.6, 5.2. Then we have 4.6, 5.2. These are the predictions. So just we need to do one thing, that is create your best fit line. It's created successfully. Any doubts still here? So now, if I can do the same thing with any of the example wherever you have x and y. So whatever x is being given to me, I'll just find out the y for you. We'll just calculate the y cap. That's it. This is the simple linear regression. Basically, y equals mx plus c, y equals y mx. So that's why I have written y minus x. So it is y bar minus mx bar, that is 2.2. Shall we move forward now? Is it clear to all of you what exactly the simple linear regression is, how to implement it mathematically? Now we need to implement the same thing using Python program. But I will take a real-time data set. Okay, we'll use a real-time data set. And I will share this particular notebook with you all. So first of all, we need pandas and numpy. I'm only going to use numpy and pandas. So do you know there is a package known as sklearn? I hope everyone know about there is a package known as sklearn. Sklearn, I'm not going to use right here because I'm not going to implement the linear regression using sklearn. Sklearn is a built-in library used for machine learning. In that particular library, there is no pain, nothing you have to do. You just have to import the linear regression is a predefined package inside that. Just pass your data in it, it will give you prediction. Okay. So I have a data set here. The package is sklearn. Okay, now let's read the file. pd.read.csv. So this is the data set we have, and data set dot shape, let's check how many number of rows and columns we have. 237 rows and 4 columns. Then let's print the head, the first 5 rows. So in this data, I'm going to take x as my head size, which is given in centimeter cubes. These are the values for x. This is the brain weight in grams, and this is going to be my y, the target. So we have x and y. So I'm saying x is my head size dot values, and y is my data set brain weight in grams dot values. How to apply on Excel data? Same, this is also Excel data. Okay, this file is CSV, but it will open in Excel. If you have Excel SX format, then you can open that here. There is a read Excel method. Instead of read CSV, there is a read Excel method. You can use that. Okay, now we have X and Y.
I have a question. This dot values, what it will do? It will take all the values in the columns.
It will give you a NumPy array.
Okay.
And if you will not write the dot values, then it will give you a series. If you remember yesterday, I told you there is a series and data frame. So it will give you series. So this is the file.
Okay.
I'm looking right there. Right there.
Sir, where the data set is stored, were it in the Google Drive or in the local machine?
Sorry, ma'am, you are not audible. Please repeat again aloud.
Hello. Sir, you just give it as a read CSV, then specify the file name. So where this data set is stored, whether it is in the Google Drive or in the local machine?
Ma'am, I'm unable to understand. You can speak a little bit loud or you can write down your query.
Okay. You just give it as a read CSV only, and then specify the data set name.
Yeah.
So where this data set is stored, whether it is in the Google Drive or in the local machine?
It is at the same location I'm working here, in my local machine. Data is here and the code file is here.
Okay, in the same folder. Okay.
So you can just write the file name directly.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I'll provide this CSV file. I'll provide it. So we have this data, gender, age range, head size, brain weight, but I'm going to use head size and brain weight. Okay. Now we have X and Y. Let's plot them using matplotlib. Yeah, I'll show you the code. Just wait a minute. I'll show the code. Okay. Now, after plotting the X versus Y, this is the output. Now, can I say the X and Y are linearly related? There's some sort of a relation of X and Y because the X is increasing and Y is also increasing. So it means I can apply linear regression on it. Okay, so let's first implement. Then we'll get back to the code. That I'll explain the code, okay? So now, according to this algorithm that we completed here, what are the steps? First, we need to calculate the slope and intercept. And formula for slope I have written here. So first thing you need is average of x and y. np dot mean of x. So that's how you can simply calculate the average, and then the mean of y is equals to np dot mean of y. So we have mean of x and y. Okay. Next thing we need is a numerator and denominator. n is equals to length of x. So the formula is numerator divided by denominator. Numerator will be x2 minus x1 into y2 minus y1. It will be divided by x2 minus x1 whole square. So I will start iterating for I in range n. Numerator plus equals to, is the code visible to all of you? Why we are taking zero? Because right now I will do plus equals to. So I am initializing numerator and denominator with zero first. So now I will start add on. It will be equals to x of I minus mean of x into y of I minus mean of y. Denominator plus equals to x of I minus mean of x whole square. Simple. Is it clear to all of you what I have written here? Numerator and denominator. And finally, the slope will be numerator divided by denominator. That's it. Now you can see the slope value, that this is 0.26 we are getting here. This is the slope we are getting. And the intercept will be is equals to mean of y minus slope into mean of x. Now we have slope and intercept, both the values here.
I have a question. So can we limit this number of digits after decimal, because it is
like pass round and pass 3, 2, 4, 1, whatever you want. But it will round off, remember, okay? So like this. Okay. So it is 263. So instead of this, so it will now 263. Similarly, you can do that for intercept. Just pass intercept, comma, 3, like this. Any doubts till here? The same thing I was teaching you in the math part here, I am doing exactly the same thing. There is no new thing I am writing in my code. The same way was mathematical part, the same here is practical implementation. Now let's find out the predictions. That is the y prediction. For I in range n, the formula for y prediction is mx plus c, that is slope into x of I plus intercept and store into the predictions list. Now you got the predictions with you. If you have missed 1 hour of session, then recordings will be provided to you by Vishal sir or any of the host. Okay, so recordings will be provided. Do not worry about whatever you have missed. So we have predictions. These are the first 10 values of my prediction. Again, these are a lot of values we are looking here. Just convert it into integer. And let's print y, the first 10 value of actual y. So this is my prediction. And this is your actual value. That's it. Okay. So there is a little bit difference that we will talk about in future, and how to deal with this thing. Now, after that, let's plot the best fit line. This is your best fit line. Okay, now tell me, is it clear or not? You can just imagine one of the simplest way to learn linear regression or machine learning. First, I just showed you the mathematical part so that you can relate because you all are aware of mathematics. There are same things are implemented using Python. Now it will become more easy for you to understand how it works. Yeah, I will show the implementation of optimization as well. Okay. No, this is not the part of text analytics. We'll start discussing about text analytics tomorrow. So tomorrow we have two sessions, and in those two sessions I'll be talking about image processing and text processing.
So Dr. Levy, we can have access to any Excel file, and we can plot whatever we want to do as
per
the data.
Exactly, same. And for the image processing or text processing part, I'll be using logistic regression. Okay, so our linear regression will be covered. Logistic regression will also be covered. So shall we move forward now? Is it clear to you all?
This is for checking whether it is linearly related or not.
Yeah. Now we finally get to know that this is linearly related because we got the best fit line here.
Relation between the two factors, like
yes.
Height size and brain weight.
Yeah, exactly.
So we can correlate for any other parameters in this manner.
Yeah, same. I'll show you one
Thank
more
you.
Example with multiple columns.
Yeah, generally we have like 4 to 5 factors. Like simply if you take demographics, like age, gender, then education status and their income status. Simple, I'm telling. Like that, if 4 or 5 factors are there.
I'll be showing you example of time series data. I have data of Apple stock market and it has open, high, low, close. So we have 4 columns and one will be my Y. So it will be an example that you can easily relate of multiple linear regression. But right now we are talking about till here. So this was the code that we have written so far. Read the file, find out the x and y, calculate their mean, plot the data, find out the slope, and to calculate the slope, this was one of the simplest implementation you will see. Then find out the numerator and denominator like this. And after getting the slope, find out the intercept. And finally, get your predictions. That's it.
When you are talking about mean, sir, can we have the standard deviation also along with that?
Yeah, there is a different method. There is a different method for standard deviation.
Okay.
We have STD for standard deviation. Okay.
So standard deviation may be a function, no? Ready function in NumPy, correct?
Yeah, it is already an existing function.
Okay.
Okay, so now what will be the next step? Because this is not machine learning. The steps we done till here, there is nothing machine has learned. What do you think machine has learned? Machine has learned nothing. Okay. So we was just implementing mathematics. We was just implementing linear regression. The statistics, this was the statistics, I think. This is not machine learning. Machine learning will start from here. Okay. Are you getting my point, everyone? What I am saying, like, this is not machine learning. This is not machine is learning something. This is just a simple mathematics, a statistical part that we have implemented to check what is my prediction. Now, machine has to learn the slope and intercept by minimizing the error and increasing the accuracy. So the first thing we have to do is to calculate So now we have to find out MSE. Why? Because the prediction are not right. The value is 2. The prediction is 2.8. Answer is 4. We have 3.4. Answer is 5. We have 4. Answer is 4. We have 4.6. Answer is 5. We have 5.2. So it means there is a difference between actual and predicted value. So that's why we have to calculate the MSE. That is the error. That is the cost of my target. So I will write down the formula for you. This is MSE, that is mean squared error. Are you getting my point, everyone, or not? Is there any doubt? Like right now, I'm talking about first you got the predictions, but after calculating the predictions, we have to find out the error. And by error, it means we have to use this formula, mean squared error. And then we have RMSE, that is the root mean squared error. Okay, so now we'll find out the error in our logic, in our program. Okay. Yes, we are going to find the difference between actual and estimated. Yes, sir. Why do we require RMSE? Because by MSE, you are squaring the differences. So RMSE is just the under root of that particular squared value. Okay, so first of all, to calculate MSE, we have by and prediction. Let's take one variable, error is equal to 0. For I in range, which one is better, MSE or RMSE? It's not like which one is better. We have to figure out both the things. If you are looking at MSE, then this is mean squared error. If you are looking at RMSE, then this is the under root version, squared version. This is the only difference. It's not like which is better to see. Both are error for me. I have to reduce both. If RMSE will be reduced, ultimately MSE is reduced. If MSE is reduced, it means RMSE is also reduced. Okay. So now for I in range n, error will be plus equals to. So now I'm going to write the formula, that is predictions of I minus y of I whole square. This is the error. It will be divided by n, and you will get mean squared error. RMSE is NP dot, yes, it should be approximately calculated to 0, but we are nowhere close to 0, sir. NP dot square root of MSE is your RMSE, that is root mean squared error. This is your root mean squared. So we have this much average error in predictions. So if someone is saying that my head size is this, then what will be my brain weight? I am predicting the brain weight, but with the average error of this value. Getting my point, everyone? there is a like very large value we have for the error. Obviously, data is also large. Data is in thousands. We cannot get value between 0 and 1 because the data is available in thousands. How can you get the error like close to 0? We'll try something. Okay. And we'll try to reduce the error. We'll see whether error will be reduced or not. It's not necessary that error will reduce because the data is not too much. We have only 237 rows. Might be this is the best output we are getting. Might be. Okay. Okay, is this clear till here? Any doubts right now? Okay, everyone confirm once. Is this clear to you all? Okay. Now for the next upcoming part that I'm going to start, I will start not today, tomorrow, but first you should learn something about gradient descent. Okay. You need to learn something about gradient descent because this is one of the, this is the machine learning actually. This is where machine is going to learn something. Okay. So please go through with this thing, and to learn about gradient descent, you must be aware of calculus, partial derivative, differentiation part. So first I am giving you to study few things about it. Then tomorrow I will teach you about this. So right now, if I will start, then it will become overburden for you. That's why I do not want to start this thing right now. Okay. So right now today, what we have learned, let's summarize the all things. We have learned a lot of things today, that how, what is machine learning, how to perform it, what is linear regression, how to implement it mathematically without any predefined packages that is going to perform linear regression for you. So this is always my first priority, that whenever you want to implement machine learning, please always do one thing. First, learn mathematics of it, implement without any package like sklearn or anything. Just implement it by yourself, like today we did. It will give you more knowledge, more detailed knowledge you will get after doing these kind of things. Okay. Now, any doubts or anything you would like to ask? What is usually the unit of value received as error? This is the average error we are getting. What will be the unit of it?
Hello, sir.
What's the difference between these two? Okay.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, hello, ma'am.
Sir, actually, here we're including the simple linear regression right now. So, when we're increasing the number of independent variables, it's becoming a multiple linear regression.
Yes.
So, what about the graph of that multiple linear regression? Is it the same one or is it any 3D plot?
If you will try linear? To plot multiple columns like more than three, it will become four dimensional. And I don't think that there is anything which could plot four-dimensional data. You can plot three-dimensional data now. But so there is one thing known as dimensionality reduction.
Okay.
So if you have heard about dimensionality reduction, if you have like 30, 40 columns, then you can reduce the dimensions of your data and then plot.
So at that time, what about the graph structure? Is it a straight line or something curve?
Whenever you are talking about linear regression, it will be a straight line.
Straight line. Okay, sir. So in multiple linear regression, the graph is also like a straight line, no?
Yeah, exactly. Same. We'll have a straight line.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you.
All like ANN, MLDL, etc., subset of ANN. So tomorrow in the evening session, I'll be talking about deep learning. Okay, then I will tell you ANN, MLDL differences. How to relate with image analysis. Tomorrow we are going to learn about image analysis and text analysis, both the things. Okay. Okay, so if you do not have any doubt, then let me upload the codes first. And I am sharing one data as well. Let me share more than one data.
Hello. Sir, good afternoon. Sir, we can use any mathematical equation for this, or you have just started with some specific? I'm confused with that.
Basically, we have started this with, because this is a part of machine learning. This equation is part of machine learning.
Okay. So what the formula you have provided that are fixed for that, that is MSC formula what you have provided, okay, so basically these all things already it is researched, means everything, this is a learning. We can, if I want to research something, then I need to change something in this. Is it exactly the same now? Yes. Thank you, sir.
From where you can get the data, there are a lot of websites. I told you yesterday, and I am going to upload few data. One is Apple stock market data that I have uploaded. I am uploading one more interesting data for you all. You can perform data analysis on Sachin Tendulkar. You can find out whether Sachin Tendulkar, I have the data set of Sachin of test matches. So basically, this data of Sachin Tendulkar, you can implement machine learning on it. Let me show you this file. So for the right, for this practice problem, what you will do is just take only two things. It will have a lot of columns, but you will take only two columns. Okay. This is the batting score, the wickets, run conceded, catches, stump. There are a lot of columns. Okay, but you will take the batting score column. Okay, the first column you will take is batting score. I think this is the data of. There is one more data I will share. That will be more better for you to practice. This data is better. Let me show you this data first. So this is the data of Sachin Tendulkar test matches. File is not corrupt. It's showing you error right now. I will open it again. Okay, so you have runs, minutes, ball phased. So there are a lot of information given here, which you can use to find out the Sachin Tendulkar prediction. Like you can do one thing. You can predict the run of Sachin based on the balls he has faced. You can do just the prediction simply like that. If Sachin is going to face 118 balls in test matches, then how many runs he's going to make or how many minutes he's going to play. Okay, so you can do this linear regression. Just take two columns from it, runs, minutes, or runs and ball phased. Just relate them and plot and do practice accordingly. But remember, the data contains also DNV values, so remove those values. So just think about how you are going to remove those values. Okay, I'm going to share this data as well with you. And this is an Excel file. So remember, you have to use read Excel. Instead of read CSV, you will be using read Excel method. Okay, so this is the data blink. I'm sharing again. Okay, so I hope you understood the concepts of machine learning. Can we use these file at any time? Anytime. I will not delete these things anytime. Okay, so you can just download anytime. 1 year, 2 year after, okay? This is permanent for you all. With that file, you have to implement machine learning, the linear regression part that we have learned today. ASCII files like what?
So a few data comes from the some of the instruments in ASCII format. So that also can we read like Excel or ASCII Python and have the plots?
Basically, if you do not have to convert ASCII data to something else, then we can read directly. If you have to convert, then first you have to use something that will be able to convert your ASCII files. How to use and upload Excel files? Simply, instead of read CSV, just use read underscore Excel method. So there is a read CSV, which reads the CSV file. There is a read Excel. Okay, let me write it down. So this is your homework. You have to read this file. You can take a screenshot of this thing so that in your homework part, it will help you how I read this file. So first import NumPy pandas, read the Excel file. This is the head. And after reading the head, I did one thing that I just deleted the data of DENV, TDENV. So just need to do something like this. These three lines, you have to copy paste these three lines in your data, okay? You can just take the screenshot, that's why I'm showing you. And after that, I will not show you the code. Tomorrow I will share this file, but today you have to practice it from your side. For tomorrow's session, we have to install the package, but right now, if I will tell you, then you might get errors. So that's why I will tell you in front of me, so that you will be easily understand them. We have to use OpenCV. So tomorrow we'll be talking about image processing and text processing. For image processing, we generally uses OpenCV, and for text processing, we uses NLTP. No, today 2 p.m. is not my session. I think someone else is taking the session, and it is not machine learning, deep learning, it is of something else, I guess. Yeah, IPR, I guess. Okay, guys, so let's meet tomorrow. Thank you, everyone.
Yes, sir, we will meet on tomorrow.
Okay, sir, you are here?
Today, just now I came back after my DC and data communication networking class.
Okay.
And sir is also with us.
Okay. Hello, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Mr. Ravi.
Good afternoon, sir.
Your session remains good, so I was also enjoying your session, right?
Okay, sir.
So we'll meet tomorrow and tomorrow both the sessions, correct?
Definitely.
All the best. I'm sure participants must have also enjoyed it. But yes, because it is a programming subject, so participants need to do a lot of practice.
Actually, they need a lot of practice.
A lot of practice, and that's how I thought that today, instead of two sessions, let's have one session, so that if there is some backlog of yesterday for practicing or maybe some preparation for tomorrow, at least they can do the practice. So in between the 2 days of practice session, there has been a theory session which we planned. So today afternoon is a theory session, important session on IPR and patent.
Yeah, they have two assignments. One is movie and one is the practical.
But no, your full movie is remaining for tomorrow, huh?
No, I just recommended a movie to watch based on AI.
Correct.
So they will watch and get to learn few new things.
Correct. Good. Okay, we'll meet tomorrow. Good session.
Okay, sir.
Thank you, Ravi sir, and thank you very much to all the participants. We will start the next session by 2 o'clock. So I request you all to please join the session by 1:45. Thank you.